is an increase in the desire to have rental houses, because very many people are moving from their home areas to town centers to look for white collar jobs. And trust me, this is making some of them comfortable, because each time they're at their workplaces, they think, you cannot construct a house on a 50 by 100 or a 50 by 50, or that is some small space someone constructed their home. Please, today we are here to guide you on how you can transition from having paying all that rent for all those years to owning your home, however small it is. We are going to be joined by Engineer Francis Xavier, who is very good at this transition. He's going to guide us. You out there will also be prompted to take that first step of owning your home. This is the Homes and Construction Show. My name is Hilda Kamkama. Let us move straight away and talk to the engineer. And who knows, me and you will be starting our journey from renting to owning our homes.
Rental income tax going up. This means that it affects the tenants directly.
Sure.
So, how can the tenants be out of this situation without really being homeless? First of all, when you look at rent is a very, I can say it's a financial prison.
Very
how?
True.
It's a financial prison because when you look at the cheapest house around Kampala, everyone has to work.
Mm-hmm.
We all have a responsibility to work. So now when you look at the cheapest house, even if you got a studio, which is only a room where you can put your TV inside, your bed, your saucepans, everything within the same room, you find that the cheapest can go for about 250 in a decent area. Now, people around Kampala, knowing that we have to move to the nearest workplace, our workplaces, definitely we are trying to reduce on the expenses.
Yes.
That's in form of transportation costs. And we're also not trying to be very tired to go to work the next day. So you find that we have to get within range.
That proximity.
Yes, close proximity of the workplace. So the house being a minimum of 250, of course it can range from like maybe 250 all the way to even to 2 million.
1 million, 2 million.
Yes, 1 million, 2 million. But if you do the math, a person who pays 250 per month, that is only in rent, other expenses exclusive. That person at the end of the year, after 12 months, will have paid 3 million
in rent.
A person who pays 350,000 will have paid 4.2 in rent a year. Then if we go all the way maybe to the cheapest two-bedroomed house, now those ones, the first ones I was talking about were probably one-bedroomed houses.
Studio,
or one bedroom plus a very small living room. So if you want a two-bedroomed house,
$600,000.
You have to go between 500 and 600. Now, if you're paying 500,000, that means you're already going to pay 6 million
a year.
Now that 6 million, if you multiply it, maybe say, if you extrapolate, you project to like the next 3 years, that you will have paid rent of 18 million. But do you know what 18 million can do?
Wow.
So if you have-
That's a lot of money.
That's a lot of money.
Actually, Ugandans have money now.
Yeah, Ugandans have money.
because
if you're renting for that long, you're paying, now we haven't even talked about someone who pays 1 million. Because if you pay 1 million in rent, at the end of the year, you're going to pay 12 million. Yes. So if you extrapolate 12 million for 3 years, that is 36 million. But you find the youth, renting houses of 1 million, even all the way to 1.5. Because if you pay 1.5 million, that means you're going to pay 18 million per year. So you find that these people actually have money, but people fear constructing. What I advise anyone whether you're just starting a family, you're just starting your life, or you're already in rent, you're already paying rent with your small family, it is yet to grow, but you're paying rent, I would advise that when, as you're paying this rent, you have a plan. You have a plan. Because once you have a plan and you try to strike a balance between how much you're paying for rent and how much you're saving towards construction. Of course, construction starts with owning a plot of land.
The plan should be saving for construction.
Yes.
The plan should be owning your own place.
Yes. You know, the issue we have with our fellow countrymen and countrywomen is they fear to buy small pieces of land. Every time someone finds a 50 by 50, you know, okay, there's a directive, probably from Ministry of Lands, that titled land starts from, the minimum requirement is 50 by 100.
Okay.
But that doesn't mean that we don't have Chibanja. We have both Milo land and Crown land. So that means if you can't afford the Milo land, the titled land, you can go for the Crown land. You know, these days they actually started processing titles. Mm. The titles are there. So what you do, you can get your 30 by 40 feet plot and you fit your house there. You can get your 50 by 50 and you fit your house there. So there is no point of renting for 10 years. If you rent for 10 years, say you pay rent, this person who pays 250,000 per year, per month, you're going to pay rent of 3 million.
Million a year?
Yes, and that means after 10 years, you will have paid 30 million.
Hmm.
But 30 million can construct a home, not just a house.
Meanwhile, you don't have a guarantee.
Yes.
Because the landlord may wake up at one time and choose to
exactly.
be like, maybe sold my property, or I want to use them so you can get
yes.
out.
Yes, yeah.
So
also the new
guarantee.
Owners, yes, and also he can, this owner can sell to another owner, and the another owner comes with different pricing.
And it does not mean that you're going to pay maybe 300,000 or 500,000 for
yes.
the 10 years.
Yeah. Of
we
course,
always
it's going
have
to...
inflation,
yeah,
which
exactly.
will directly come back to the rent.
Yeah.
If it's been 500, maybe it can even go up to like 700,000.
Yes. And also, like you introduced our program today, rental tax is also key. The moment rental tax is increased, also the rent is going to increase. So you find that even if you're renting a house of 300,000, maybe within 5 years, you will be at 500 in the same place.
Yeah.
For us as contractors, we people in construction, we have houses that we manage. So we know these things. When a building is new, we pull customers by putting it at a favorable rate that is competitive in the market. But when people get comfortable, there is always that small increase in the rent. It might be very small, but it's very key. Yes, because when you calculate that small increment along the number of years, if you distribute it, it's actually a lot of money. So this means that if you can avoid rent, please do it. How? This is by striking a balance between your expenses and also your savings.
As your,
yes.
You have mentioned that if you can avoid renting.
Yes.
Now on that very note, we need to, because there are very many people that are renting.
Yes, that's correct.
We may not know why they are still there. Maybe they are comfortable, or they are not thinking about tomorrow, or they don't even have sufficient information about someone constructing maybe a home on a
yes.
small piece of land.
Hmm.
Now you're here.
Yes.
We need to know how much land is required for one to get a comfortable home.
How much land is required? I can say maybe the smallest piece of land where someone can have a decent home with a small family. Maybe probably they have a car, one car. They have a very small compound. We can start with 30 feet by 40 feet. Now that is a chibanja. It's a chibanja, but a house can go on 30 and by 40 and everything is very functional.
What
the home is functional.
What can I get on a 30 by 40 feet?
You can get
lot of land.
You can get a minimum of a one-bedroomed house. By one-bedroomed, I don't mean a studio.
Mm.
That means you can get your bedroom spacious enough, And then you can also get your sitting room. You get a space to put your dining. You get a small kitchen that's just big enough for the family, and also a store. That is just enough. Now, so along there, yes.
30 by 40 feet.
Yes, yes.
You can be able to get a home that in like the real estate business or on the market, you rent it at 1 million.
Yes.
You get, apparently, like you can be paying 1 million to have that home, apparently, if you move around to the renting and stuff like that. But then at 30 by 40, you can get it and it is yours.
Yes, that's correct. You know, like I said, renting is like a financial prison. Mm. The reason why most people do not construct, first, number one is they fear constructing. They have this mindset that construction is very expensive.
Which is?
Of course, it is very expensive, but where you're sitting comfortably is also someone's property. Yeah. So this means that the fact that they can do it, now we don't have the same financial muscle. We are not the same people financially.
Sure.
But this is all commitment. Even the person who constructed that same apartment or rental that you're renting at that very moment didn't wake up one day and said, now I'm putting up this structure just to get money. Because that's a long-term investment. So it's just proper planning, saving towards it, and also ensuring that if you're committed to that, then you do it. That's why we advise people. That's why you see people save money at hardwares. Because these days, hardwares have accounts. When someone gets like 10 bags of cement, say cement is maybe at 33,000, someone gets a 330,000, off their salary, they will go and deposit it on the account. So with time, that money, you've bought cement, you've bought iron sheets, you've bought nails. So the only things you're left to buy and you're saving towards now, this money on your account will be the sand, will be the bricks, things that you can't pay forward.
Yeah.
Now, the reason it's a financial prison, say I earn 1 million.
Because I wanted also to look at our minimum wage here in Uganda.
Yes.
And I think 1 million is fair enough.
1 million is fair enough. So if we have like, if say I'm paid 1 million in wages or salary a month, I'll be very comfortable renting a house of 500,000. How? Because if I pay rent of 500, and I maybe my workplace is in close proximity.
So that you're means reducing on the, you are basically reducing on the transportation.
Exactly. And say they give me food at my workplace. So I won't break down the expenses, but you see my expenses are reducing. So that means I'm going to be comfortable. I can provide for myself. I can pay my own rent. So with time, that comfort puts you in that financial prison. So if say you get a promotion and maybe they pay you now 1.5, you find that you might find another place that is maybe 700. So that is why you find that there are so many people renting. Now, instead of downscaling, very comfortably, instead of downscaling from say 500 to 300 with a plan of maybe
5 to 200.
Yes.
Or maybe also adding the 200
to some of the savings.
Yes. If you've gotten a promotion, maybe planning to have also that one saved.
Exactly.
Towards the plan of owning your own home.
Exactly. The first thing you have to look for is a place to construct. However small, there is no land that is small for your home. As long as, like we said, if you have a 30 by 40, which is unlikely that someone will look for a 30 by 40, but say they get a 30 by 40, you can have your comfortable home there. There is no beautiful apartment when you don't own it.
I know.
So however beautiful someone's apartment is,
it's not yours.
It is not yours. The moment you're renting someone's apartment and you make it very beautiful, you know, you go all out. You buy the nice sofas, the biggest TV. Generally, you'll be very comfortable. Someone comes to your home and they say, oh, this gentleman has a very nice home. But it's not your house. It's not your house. The moment you get that comfort, that means you're going to be comfortable for a lengthy period of time. And the more you be comfortable with rent, the more you'll stay in rent. But the moment you take a step towards getting out of rent, and that step is buying a small piece of land, That is the first step towards getting out of rent. You know, the most of the people who are actually renting, their first goal is buying a car, which isn't bad because different people, different direction.
Yeah, because actually cars apparently are not a luxury. It's
It's more of a necessity. Yeah. It's an essential, especially when you're, depending on your schedule. But what I'm trying to say is, even when you get your small piece of land, however distant, I brought in the car to tell the viewers that however distant you might be away from your workplace, you have your car that you purchased that can help you maneuver around all the way to your workplace. If you're more of a field person, you can maneuver around the field. So this means that even if you get outside of Kampala, you don't really have to be so close. You know, when you're renting, you have to avoid being distant from work. But then when you're owning your own home, don't expect to be close to work.
Yeah, it doesn't actually matter the distance from your workplace or the distance from the city center.
Yes.
As long as it is your home.
Yes. Because now let me put it in this way. If you rent and you're trying to maybe minimize your rental income, your rental expense, and say you go distant from your workplace in a way of trying to just mitigate this high expense on rent, you're going to face high expenses on transportation.
Okay. In this context, you maybe work from New Vision.
Yes.
And you're running away from rent of 400,000.
Yes.
And then someone tells you, no, here in Wakiso.
Exactly. You can get a 250.
You can get 250 or 150.
Yes.
Maybe.
Yes.
So you're like, now that's a whole deal. Let me shift from where I am to Wakiso.
So that I save. Yes, it catches up with you in terms of expenses. Because first of all, whether you're using private means, if you're using private means, that's more fuel. If you're using public means,
still transport.
That's fare. Still a lot of transportation fares. But if you're using private means and you're that distant, the expense you have is fuel. You're not paying rent. So this means that you can go all the way out of Kampala, all the way to Wakiso, for example, and still manage the fuel expense without really putting a dent in your pockets.
Because you're going to your home.
Because you're going to your home. The only expense you have in terms of transportation is your fuel. But if you have your car, you have transportation, fuel expenses, and you also have to go at the end of the month and pay the rent, even if it's 250,000 or 200,000 or even 150,000, you still have a dent of the rental expense. So this means that however small the plot is, you try as much to save towards this and purchase that plot, however distant it might be. Then this will help you build your first home. How? By drawing a strategy. You won't just wake up one morning and say, now I have 3 million, let me construct. You plan, get yourself an engineer, draw yourself a plan. Then you make a BOQ. Then you plan towards that. Even if you don't do all that, for example, if you want to be ready at once, this person can help you and guide you professionally.
At what stage do I really need to get an engineer?
If you want consultation, you can start right away. Because this is just consultation.
Even
it's just
without
like,
saving, you really shouldn't have, like, save maybe like 3 million already. You can just be starting.
Yes, you can just be starting initially. Okay. Like say you have zero into savings.
But you have a desire.
But you have a desire to construct. Yes. So you call your engineer, talk to them, consult them about how you can mitigate the high expenses in rent, how you have a desire to construct, what kind of structure you want, and what home is enough. You know, some people fear constructing because they will say that if I construct a very big home, it will be very expensive. As long as it's your home, it will not be expensive because this is a home you can move into before you plaster. This is a home you can move into before you paint. This is a home you can move into before you pave and all those other exquisite finishes. As long as you have shelter, you've put your doors, you've put your windows, you've put lighting, you've put water, that is enough. and you have shelter, which is the roof, that is enough. You move into that. Now that actually pushes you to complete your house. Now,
also looking at if you've been paying rent faithfully every month, now you can use that, you can divert that much money you've been paying your landlord to buying like a few bags of cement and try fixing a few things in the house. Of course,
that is very true. The money that you would have paid in form of rent to the landlord can go into buying things that you need. You can buy cement, you can buy iron bars, you can buy and you know, the thing with construction is the moment you start, it's very demanding. So as long as you commit, the first step is commitment. As long as you commit to constructing your home, you will complete that home. The mistake people make is trying to play it safe. By playing it safe, I mean, what if I start and don't finish? What if I start and this happens? I mean, everything about life is a risk.
And there's one thing that I've also learned, because I mean, this is life, and I believe by now we know this already. Seriously.
Yes.
Success is on the other side of fear.
Exactly.
If you fear something, you'll never move. You never take a step. You never do anything.
Yes.
So ideally, fear is just there to stop you from reaching greater heights.
Exactly. Mm. Every time you fear to start something, you will never do it.
Mm.
And what happens? You become comfortable with your current situation. And every time you become comfortable in your current situation, you keep on holding, you hold on to your fears, isn't it?
Now the years are more, remember, you're not growing young.
Exactly.
So eventually your 40 years,
it catches up with you.
You do not have a roof on your own, like for your own.
Yes.
And you know what?
Mm.
Statistics will start like popping, saying the number of mental...
We start getting issues of mental health.
That is what is happening. Because mental health, they tell you it's on the right.
Yes.
Because someone is thinking, I don't have friends.
There's too much stress, yes.
Maybe even you've lost a job.
Yes.
Your source of income, right?
Exactly. Yeah. Now, you imagine you lost your job under your own roof. The comfort you would get is, as you're trying to get an option elsewhere, you're not paying rent. Because, trust me, it is a catastrophe. It is very catastrophic to lose your job in a 1 million house.
I know.
You cannot spend 5 months in that house without feeling stress. You'll be very depressed. If you have a family, you're going to put the stress on that family. And the next thing we know,
suicide.
Even if you don't commit suicide, the family itself is in shambles.
You're right.
Because the kids are stressed, your wife is stressed, or your husband is stressed. And this is going to cause
domestic violence,
mental health, and everything. And everything else in that line. So, if you are able to save, if you have the chance to save yourself out of rent, please take the steps. There is no plot that is too small to construct. Now, like you asked, what is the smallest plot? I would think that a 30 by 40 is sufficient for a one-bedroomed house with a sitting room and self-contained, a toilet inside and a bathroom, a kitchen and then a store. But when you go all the way, there are people who say that, no, that is too small. What if I get money later and I want to upgrade? If you get a 50 by 50, you might be comfortable. You might be comfortable enough. You can actually put up a three-bedroomed house.
50 by 50. I can get a bedroom.
A three-bedroom house. Because how we do this, the 50 is in feet. That is 50 feet.
True.
So if you have 50 feet, the minimum space for a bedroom that is recommended would be 3 by 3 feet.
So
no, 3 by 3 meters. Sorry.
3 by 3. So for three bedrooms, you can, that's like 10.
So for three bedrooms, remember they are not going on one side. So at most you have two bedrooms on one side, then the other bedroom on the other side with the sitting room. So you see what I'm trying to get to.
Then the two bedrooms
can share maybe the bathroom. Then one can be self-contained. Exactly. So that means that if you have 3 meters, is about 9 feet, or you say 10 at most. So if you have 9 feet plus 9 feet, that is a total of 18. So if you have a 50 by 50 and you subtract your 18, what is the balance? You have a balance of 32 feet. So if you have a balance of 32 feet on either side, that means you still have a compound. You have enough space. You have space to leave at the back for your hang line. You have space at the front to put a very small garden, all enough green, and also a small area to pave for one or two cars. That I think that is a very good home for anyone with a big family, or to start with projecting that in the end, you still have a big family. By a big family, I don't mean you go and give birth to 12 children. I mean four yeah. kids, mom, dad, and a maid. That is a big family that actually needs three bedrooms. So if you do that, you don't have to complete that house first. If you construct your three bedrooms, the shell house, and then you put your conduits and plaster inside. The key is plastering inside so that it doesn't look so shabby and very uncomfortable for you. Because the moment it's shabby, of course, you're attracting very many things, maybe insects and birds. But as long as you organize it, you plaster, you don't have to tile it yet. You can even start with new. There's nothing you can do in construction that can't be renovated. Even if you don't have money for the tiles, you start with your cement new, that cement finish that is shiny, that has a glossy look. Then later on, if you get the money for tiles, all you have to do is to scrap that cement new off. And then you create a rough surface to receive the tiles. You put the flow screed.
This has just been a preamble. Please don't miss in our second part, where we are going to be giving you the mathematics of how you can own a home in your small space of land, especially the ones that are staying in the urban centers.